couple things here tonight. First of all, I want to answer a question several of you asked after the morning, and that is, what exactly did Luther believe in reference to baptism? I think most of you are aware that Lutherans do practice infant baptism in the same way that the Presbyterians do, not believing in regeneration, but rather believing that it is a sort of promise of God's work in that life in the future, but not a guarantee. It varies, of course, depending on the group that you're talking about. But Luther himself was very clear about his perspective on works of any kind. I just want to share with you a couple of quotes to put it in perspective. Here's what he writes. Human reason looks to the law. This I have done, this I have not done. But when faith performs its proper office, it looks to absolutely nothing except Jesus Christ, the Son of God, given for the sins of the whole world. It does not say, what have I done? Which sin have I committed? What have I merited? It rather says, what has Christ done? What has he merited? So, I mean, very clear. Here's another example. He says, our learned men in schools for higher learning have said this, he that believes, he's quoting a New Testament text, he that believes, understand, and does good works shall be saved. Who has commanded them to make this addition? Do you suppose the Holy Spirit is so stupid that he could not have added these words? So they have completely obscured, nay, they have perverted this noble passage with this addition. See to it, therefore, that you allow no one to make an addition for you, but that you stay with words just as they read, and that you understand them in this way. He that believes shall be saved, without his merit or any work.